front tonight, breaking news, death penalty. That is what fired Atlanta Police Chief Police Officer Garrett Wolf could be facing if convicted in the deadly shooting of Rayshard Brooks in a Wendy's parking lot. Cabbage is out front from Tulsa. And Martin, you're there on the ground. So what else have Tulsa officials said today about the rally?
Yeah, I'll get to that in just a second. Let me show you this already behind us. That's 400 people waiting to get in. That line actually started forming last Saturday. The gates don't open until this coming Saturday. You could say they're dedicated supporters of the president, but the health department here would say they're in danger if they go inside the OK Center here. Let me point out, just reiterating what was said by Dr. Bruce Dark, because what came out of that press conference today from health officials is downright scary. First of all, you already reported 96 new cases. That is a record daily increase in Tulsa. It supplants the previous record, which was set on Monday. That was 89. Then on top of that, they've got 595 confirmed active cases, 64 deaths. Early last week, they said they began to see a marked increase of new cases. Since June 6th, they have seen a significant increase in hospitalization. So the red flags are flying. The red lights are flashing. The alarm bells are going off. Health officials are saying they've got a full-blown coronavirus spike in Tulsa right now, and into that this weekend will come about 100,000 people who attend the rally. I asked the director of the health department for the county, that being the case, why has he not gone to city officials and said you cannot hold this rally because it's a danger to public health? Here's what he said to my question.